thing comes, another problem for your, what can I say? This is another problem for your this thing, top-down person. Okay, that is called late factoring. So a predictive parser or a top-down parser without a backtracking. Okay, so what is backtracking in top-down parser? So what is this? I am telling you in short that if say you have started with a start symbol AS, okay, started driving and so on, and after a certain time you have found that okay, no further derivation is possible. Okay, no derivation is possible. Okay, but in some place you had something like this, you know, S to A small a, and you had also S to A B. So this situation you had, and in the first case, you know, in this derivation, you had chosen say S to A, and you did, and after and choosing this, after some time you found that no more derivations are possible. So at this point, what you can do, where you had taken, you know, you had chosen one of the production rule over another production rule, you track back, you just go back to that point and try to choose the another production rule which was available, okay, and again you try to, you know, do the derivation step by step. Okay, so this is what called a backtracking. Okay, so that you just get a chance to do correction of your choice. Okay, so grammar, a new equivalent. So you have a grammar, so what you have to do, you have to write a new equivalent grammar suitable for predictive parsing. Okay, so if we look at this if else problem, statement equal to if expression then statement else statement. You all understand this very well, right? Then if expression then statement. Okay, so there is two things, that one is if else, if with else, and another is only if there is no else, right? So when we say if, see if you in the code you got some situation like if a greater than 0, some statement, okay, and then at this point this else is there or not, how will you know? Because you are just going through token by token. If you are reading here, you know, you are doing a left to right read. You are reading this from left to right. So left, at the leftmost position, if is there, how do we know that after some time, you know, 1.1 token, lexem 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, more than 6 or 7 lexems, you are going to get an else. So at this point, when you are doing this derivation or preparing our parsing tree, it is very hard to predict that or it is not there. See, if S is there, we have to choose this. If S is not there, we have to choose this. But it is not possible to see this much in future whether S is coming or S is not coming. So in this situation, by looking at if itself, we just choose one of them. Now, if there is no else, and we have chosen the first rule, you know, after some time, when this statement will be read out, and after statement, say there is instead of else, there is something else, say there is a shoe. Okay, there is no else, there is shoe. Then this production rule is not going to work for you. Understand? So what you can do, you can just track back. Okay, you can backtrack to to that step where you had chosen this production rule, this past production rule, by looking at if here in the input token. Okay, so this is what backtrack you do. Then again you choose the alternative one and it can work for you. Okay, so when we say if we cannot know which production rule to choose to rewrite statement in the derivation, that is what I just discussed. Okay. All right. So, in general, A2, alpha beta 1 and alpha beta 2, if you have, then only, you know, say alpha is any terminal. Okay. So, that if I say the first alpha is non terminal, then you will feel like left recursion. But you assume that first alpha are some terminal. Okay. So, you have two choices. When you are looking at alpha or first alpha, which one you to choose? Okay, here alpha is non-empty, and the first symbol of beta 1 and beta 2. Okay, so if they have one or different, okay, that means this beta 1 and beta 2 are different. Okay, but this alpha are same. Now, when we are processing alpha, we cannot know whether to expand with A2 alpha beta 1 or A2 alpha beta 2. There is a confusion which one to choose. But we can rewrite the grammar as follows. If we can rewrite like this, A2 alpha A dash. Then you decide A dash will be beta 1 or beta 2. Then you say you don't have this problem of this, whether going with this or going with this. Right? So this method, this rewriting is called left factoring. Okay? So this is called what? Left factoring. Okay? So I don't need all these many gammas to prepare. One gamma is okay. Okay. So A to A alpha gamma we can write, and then we do A dash to beta 1 to beta n. Okay. So this can be, if this is a form we got, then we can rewrite it like this. Okay. So that there is the left factoring can be done. Understand? So how left factoring and left recursion is different? See, when we speak about left recursion, when we say left recursion, what happens there? We have A to A, then something called say alpha. Okay. And when we are speaking about left factoring, in this case, we are doing what? We have A2 alpha beta 1, and we are saying this, that this alpha is a non-empty terminal, or it can be non-terminal also, but definitely not to A. Okay. Okay. And it is alpha is first of beta. Okay. So this is what is the difference between left factoring and left recursion. And all right. Now come to this example. If you look at this. We have a few production which are headed by A to A B B. Then you have A to A B. Then the others are simple like A to C D G C D E and B, A to C D F and B. Now if you look very minutely at this in a set of production rules. A to A B B or A to A B. These two are having left factoring problem because both of them are starting with a non-terminal E, right? So this is the situation with the first two rules and second and if you look at third rule to onwards, that in these three rules, the problem is that everything is starting with CD, A to C D G, then A to C D, then E B, and another you have C D to F B. Okay, so we got two left recursive problem. So step by step we have to solve it. Okay, so first we have to look at this, how we can remove this left factoring, okay, or how we can do left factor this production rules. So what we will do, we will introduce a new variable A dash, okay, and we rewrite this as A to small a capital A dash, okay, and A dash to this two part, okay, B capital B or only B, okay. So this is a solution for the first pair of rules, okay. And we have another set of rules which are having left factoring. So this can be again rewritten as A to C. We can introduce a new variable A double dash. Okay. And we can do like A double dash to C D together you put here because C D both are giving you this problem. Okay, so C D I put here. So A dash 2, we have G from here, then E B from here, then F B from here. Alright. Then what else we have to look into? Is there anything to look into? No, nothing is going to hamper anything on us in the further. So we have to do a simple step. A to small a dash you add here, and from a dash you just generate d. I'm just adding epsilon as Charmi has also added, and later I will come to this point. Epsilon, then from this B, from this B, C, we'll add B and C both. Okay. No, sorry. I'm doing some mistakes still. let me remove all. Yeah, what mistake I was doing, let me tell you. See, this is AB here, AB here, and AB here. So these two production rules are having common symptom, right? AB, AB together, right? And here A is here and A is here. So these two are having similar problem, right? So what we can see or what we can do, we can do like this. A, no issue. Okay, break down with A on the one symbol. Okay, otherwise it will be problem. So what I was doing, that is okay. You put A here, then A dash, then from A dash to D, or A gone, the only epsilon left, okay, B, then B, C, and then we have only B here, okay. Now, at this point, if you see this original production rule, this A never produces epsilon. A to epsilon from here, this is not possible. So we have to reduce, or we will not write this production rule. Alright? This is the first thing. Next thing is that A dash to D, okay, no issue. There is no other, you know, starting with D, but there are production rules which are starting with B. B here, B here, and B here. So I have to reduce them. So what we do? A dash to B, A double dash. Okay? And A double dash to, so A to D we can keep here itself, okay. Then this B is removed, so you can say that epsilon is there, okay. Then this B gone, so this C is here, so C will come here, this B gone, okay. So epsilon can come here, okay. This B will be there itself, not here. We have to do very minutely. A small mistake can lead us to wrong result. Okay, so this B was not having any. This B was not having any problem. So definitely, though no left factoring problem is there. So this B will come here to here. Okay, then these are the production rules which are starting with A. So A dash came, now A dash 2, this D came here, this after this we assume the epsilon came here, then BC is here, so BC, sorry, AB is there, so B here, so this B came here, and BC is here, so this BC came here. Okay, now at this point what we are finding that this A dash is having again the same problem. So we are doing A dash 2. So this part is just rewritten like this. A dash 2. This D as it is can come here. And B here, B here, so B came here. And A double dash is added here. Now next, A double dash equal to epsilon and C. Now again, this epsilon is not needed, we can remove it. So the final thing what we are getting is that after rewriting A to A, A dash or B Next is A dash to D or B or B C. Sorry, this is very written. Chapter. So after rewriting it, we will get A dash to and those parts which are not having this left recursion, right? So these two thing was this two thing was rewritten as due to the left factoring, right? Then we got A dash 2 by rewriting B, A double dash, and D. Now A double dash to C. Okay, so this is our final result. All right. So you can see here the step by step solution. Okay. The same thing is done here, you know. All these A's was there, so A dash came here, A dash. A came as common one, right? Then we got D epsilon, B, BC, okay? Then A dash to D epsilon, B, A double dash, and A double dash to epsilon and C, okay? So you can see that AT epsilon, this is not there, right? It is not there. We have to note that.